Running in place with your knees up engages the core and all the muscles in your legs. It improves flexibility, coordination, hip mobility, the strength of hip flexors. Hey, we could all be a little more hip. And get your heart rate up. Get in the starting position with your feet hip-width apart. Lift your right knee to the chest. Put it down. Do the same with the left knee. Keep up with the movement and speed up. Focus on your lower abs and activate your core. The point is to always raise your knees to 90-degree angles in the hips. Watch out for these common mistakes. When you lean your torso too far forwards or backwards, stomp with your foot or swing your arms too much. Do a natural light arm movement the same you do when jogging. 1 minute of such warm-up is enough. Squats. Stand straight with your feet a little bit wider than the hips. Point your toes slightly outward. Choose a spot on the wall to keep looking at the entire workout. Put your arms in front of you and keep them parallel to the floor. The balls of your feet and the heels, that's where the weight of your body should be. Start sending your hips backward first. Then bend your knees and push your pelvis back. Go down and stop when your hip joint is lower than the knees. Breathe in. Focus on staying straight and tight as you go up. Breathe out. Squeeze your glutes when you get to the top. Common mistakes? When you don't keep your knees in line with the feet, don't move your knees toward each other. Next, jumping jacks. Stand upright, put your legs together and arms at the sides. Bend your knees a bit, jump into the air, and spread the legs to the width of your shoulders. Arms go out and over your head, then jump back to where you started. Common mistakes? When you put your arms by your sides while the feet are out wide, or anything else that puts you out of rhythm. Keep the posture straight and firm. It can be easier with good shoes on, since it's a high-impact exercise that may put stress on your feet or knees. 1 minute, go! Push-ups are great for building shoulders, triceps, and pectoral muscles. Go down into the plank position, place your hands under the shoulders or just a little bit wider, palms flat on the floor or a mat. Keep your arms and legs straight, feet together, back flat. Pull your abs in, then bend your arms and go down until your chest almost touches the floor. Stop a little bit there, and push yourself back up. Here's some common mistakes. When the hands are too far forward, you don't use your core or abs properly, which can stress out some other muscles or worse, your joints. Number two, elbows are pointed out to the side, which can cause shoulder pain. And the last one is when hips are too low. Use your abs to stabilize the entire body and level your hips with the shoulders. If the basic variation is too hard for you right now, prop yourself on your knees instead of the toes. Reverse lunges work on your glutes, thighs, and calves. You know, little cows. Nah. Stand up straight, place your hands on the hips. Now take a big step back with your right foot. While doing that, go low with your hips so your front one is parallel to the floor with the knee over the ankle. Your right knee is pointed toward the floor and is bent at a 90-degree angle, heel lifted. Now, go back to the starting position by pressing your right heel into the floor. Change the leg now. Some common mistakes? You don't bend the back knee enough. That way, you're straining your hip flexors. Make a broad step or you risk losing your balance. Don't lean too far backward, engage your core, and keep your abdominals firm and tight to stay straight. Mountain climbers are a great cardio exercise that strengthens your core. No, really. Get into a push-up position, hands shoulder-width apart. Make sure your weight is evenly distributed between your toes and your hands. Pull your right knee closer to the right elbow, touch it if possible, then put it back to the starting position. Do the same with the other leg. Now, catch the rhythm and prepare to sweat. Common mistakes? When your hips are too low, you can hurt your back and add some extra strain on the spine. Don't favor or lean on one side after you lift one leg off the ground. Hips need to stay even, and your body has to be stable. Don't bounce on your toes. It may seem more difficult at first, but it doesn't engage your core, nor does it keep it stable. Bicycle crunches are an intermediate variation of the basic crunch where you work on both your obliques and abs. Lie on your back, bend the knees with the feet hip-width apart on the floor. Put the arms behind your head. You can interlace your fingers, but make sure your elbows are wide and pointing outward. Bring your knees up and keep them at 90 degrees. Lift the upper part of your body a little bit. Careful, you don't want to strain your neck. Now you're in the starting position. Exhale while rotating your torso. Start moving with the right elbow and left knee towards each other. Focus on the movement. Strength needs to come from the rib cage, not the elbows. Take 1 to 2 seconds while there, then inhale and go back to the center. Do the same with the left elbow and right knee. That's one rep. Common mistakes? You tug on your neck when the elbow and knee are getting closer toward each other. Unlace your fingers so you're not tempted to cheat and push your head. Rotate from your core only, not from your hips or neck. Keep the shoulders relaxed and your lower back on the floor. Don't sprint through these crunches and do them too fast because you'll miss engaging some of the important ab muscles. Control the movement and slow down if needed. Butt kicks. They work your cardiovascular system, strengthen muscles, and boost endurance. Place your feet hip-width apart with arms at the sides. Bring the right heel to your buttocks. Then place the ball of the right foot back to the starting position and do the same with the other one. Repeat it a couple of times and then build up speed like you're jogging in place. This exercise is great for your lower body, but you can work the upper part too. Pump the arms at the same time. When the right heel is kicking your butt, pump the left arm forward, bent at a 90-degree angle. Common mistakes? If you don't engage your core, you may lose stability or straight position. Make sure your upper body is tense. Don't land on your heels, but on the balls of your feet. And the ultimate challenging and one of the most tiring exercises on the list, burpees. It's a two-part exercise with a push-up, after which comes a leap in the air. Boing! It burns calories and activates muscles in both lower and upper body. Legs, hips, glutes, abs, arms, shoulders, and chest. What did I leave out? Ears! Get into a squat position with your back straight, knees bent, and feet shoulder-width apart. Place your hands on the floor so they're between your feet and transfer weight on them. Now, kick your feet back so you're in a push-up position on your hands and toes with your back straight. Do one push-up, then jump your feet back to where you started. Get up from the squat, stand straight, and reach the arms over your head. Jump up and get back to the starting position upon landing. Then, do it all again. Common mistakes? Landing on your heels. Since this exercise involves jumping, make sure not to stress out your knees and ankles by landing wrong. Land gently on the balls of your feet so that your calf muscles take the pressure. If you reorder these exercises, make sure to keep burpees among the last ones on the list. It's complex and you want to be warmed up well before doing these. Don't let your hips sink. They need to be aligned in a straight line with the torso and knees. Tighten your glutes and abs to avoid that. Do the easier version if you can't do the regular one. Make it slower and without the push-up. I'm tired just watching the pictures. Time for a nap.